friends, welcome to day 16 current affairs. The first news is farmers government to continue talks. Friday talks failed to break impasse, but both sides agree to meet again on Jan 19th. So farmer unions and government is going to meet again on Jan 19th. Here image you can see Bharatiya Kisan Union leader Rakesh Tikait and other farmer leaders leaving Vignan Bhavan after discussions with union ministers on Friday. The ninth round of talks between the center and the farmer unions on Friday failed to break the impasse over the demand to repeal the three contentious farm laws. It was, however, agreed to continue the direct dialogue in parallel with the Supreme Court appointed panels proceeding on the same issue. Okay. Tractors parade. Supreme Court may pass orders on Monday. The Supreme Court is scheduled to hear the farmers' protest case on Monday amid reports that one of the four members of its expert committee set up on January 12 to negotiate between the government and the farmers has recused himself. Okay. This is about the farmers are going to meet again on Jan 19th with union minister amid failed talk between government and farmers on Friday. Second, world's largest vaccination programs begins today. Jan 16 is going to be a remarkable day in India because it going to be the a day for the vaccination starts in India for the COVID-19 disease. It will be one of the remarkable day. Okay. PM to launch drive more than 3 lakh to get jab on first day. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will flag off the first phase of the nationwide COVID-19 vaccination drive at 10:30 a.m. on Saturday during a video conference. Who should not to be vaccinated? Yesterday also I have given some information regarding vaccination. Similarly here also you can see those aged 18 or below, pregnant and lactating women, people with history of allergic reaction to COVID-19 vaccination or to vaccines in general or injectable therapies, pharmaceutical products and food items. Okay. Who are permitted? People with a history of COVID-19 infection, those with a history of chronic disease and comorbidities, people who have immunodeficiency or HIV and patients on immunosuppression drugs. Okay. There will be a dedicated call center. A dedicated 24/7 call center 1075 has been set up to address queries related to the pandemic and the vaccine rollout, the Prime Minister's office said in a statement. Okay. Policy cloud delays Brazil vaccine flight. Actually, Covishield should reach the Brazil, but there is a delay. A special plane from Brazil to carry the first exports of Covishield, the India-made coronavirus vaccine, was delayed on Friday amid confusion over clearance for shipment, officials said. Some confusions in the clearance, etc. Okay. Next. It is in Hyderabad. 4,100 sanitation staff to be vaccinated. First, 4,100 sanitation staff going to be vaccinated. 3.15 lakh health workers to get vaccines in coming days in Telangana. Medical staff inside a COVID-19 vaccination center at Eragada Chest Hospital in Hyderabad on Friday. About 4,100 sanitation workers will be given vaccine against COVID-19 at 139 centers across the state to mark the launch of the nationwide program on Saturday. After Prime Minister Narendra Modi's inaugural address in virtual mode at 10:30 a.m, 30 beneficiaries who registered themselves with COVIN, a mobile app for India to get COVID vaccine, will be administered the doses at each center on day 1. The number of beneficiaries will be gradually increased from Monday and centers will also go up to a maximum of 12-13 during the period, said Director of Medical Education K. Ramesh Reddy and Director of Public Health J. Srinivas Rao. They told a press conference on Friday that about 3.15 lakh public and private health workers, including doctors and nurses, will get the vaccine after the sanitation workers get inoculated. The second phase of the program will be for people above 50 years of age and those suffering from comorbidities. The vaccination will be only on Mondays, Tuesdays, Thursdays and Fridays. So only vaccination will be on Monday, Tuesday, Thursday and Friday. Only four days a week will be available. Okay. In Hyderabad, the vaccination will be given at 13 centers, including Gandhi and Usmania General Hospital, ENT Hospital, Chest Hospital, Kingkoti, Nampally, Vanastipulam, Golconda, and Kondapur area hospitals. Okay. Next, Air Force Academy to celebrate its Golden Jubilee today. Celebrations to culminate on Jan 19. Air Chief Marshal R.K.S. Bhaduria will release a special postal cover on the last day of celebrations. Air Force Academy Dundigal will celebrate its Golden Jubilee on Saturday. Has been rendering yeoman services ever since its inception by training and commissioning brave and distinguished officers of the Indian Air Force from its famed portals, an official release said. Okay. The foundation stone of the Air Force Academy was laid by Zakir Hussain, the then President of India, on October 11, 1967. On Jan 16, 1971, Kasu Brahmanand Reddy, former Chief Minister, inaugurated the academy. Okay. First Air India direct flight to Chicago takes off. The Air India flight will operate with a Boeing 777-200LR aircraft with a seating capacity of 238. The first ever non-stop service of Air India between Hyderabad and Chicago commenced with a maiden flight arriving at the Rajiv Gandhi International Airport in the early hours of Friday. The flight operating on Wednesdays left Chicago at 9:30 hours local time on Jan 13 and arrived at 1 a.m. The launch of first non-stop service between Chicago and Hyderabad. Telangana Governor to launch Saksham 2021 today. Oil conservation campaign to end on February 15. Tamilisai Soundararajan. Means Governor Dr. Tamilisai Soundararajan will address a webinar on Saturday to mark the inauguration of Saksham Samrakshan Kshamata Mahotsav 2021 Oil Conservation Campaign in Telangana. A nationwide initiative, Saksham 2021, will be held from Jan 16 to February 17. The campaign, consisting of various programs, is being organized by Petroleum Conservation of Research Association, Union Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, to sensitize people about conservation and efficient use of petroleum products for better health and environment. You can remember that Saksham 2021 or Saksham 20, Saksham is program related to the oil conservation. Okay, it will be an important news for exams. Next, BDL science packed with tails to make Star Streak missile system. The missile system is unique due to its three laser guided darts. City-based Bharat Dynamic Limited under the Ministry of Defence and Thales have signed a teaming agreement to work in partnership on the Star Streak air defence system with the support of both the Government of India and the United Kingdom. The system is to develop under the Make in India programs. The Star Streak missile system is in service in the British Army and has been procured by defence forces worldwide. It is touted to be the fastest missile in the category and the missile system unique due to three laser-guided darts, which cannot be jammed by any known countermeasure. The system also has the capability to defeat any air targets, even armed helicopters, as the last line of the defense, said an official spokesperson. So it is the news that BDL science pack with Thales, UK, BDL India. Okay. Biden unveils $1.9 trillion relief package. Plan aims at speeding up vaccination, providing $1,400 via checks to Americans and boosting the economy. Joe Biden outlining his plan to combat COVID-19 and deal with economic crisis in Wilmington. President-elect Joe Biden has unveiled $1.9 trillion coronavirus plan to end a crisis of deep human suffering by speeding up vaccinations and pumping out financial help to those struggling with the pandemic's prolonged economic fallout. Okay. He unveiled $1.9 trillion relief package. Next, mounting pressure on China. US blacklists Xiaomi and CNOOC. It adds 9 more to the list of Chinese firms with military links. Shoppers walking past a Xiaomi outlet in Beijing on Thursday. The US government has blacklisted Chinese smartphone maker Xiaomi Corporation and China's third largest national oil company for alleged military links, heaping pressure on Beijing in President Donald Trump's last week in office. The Department of Defense added 9 companies to its list of Chinese firms with military links, including Xiaomi and state-owned plant manufacturer Commercial Air Corporation of China Comac. Okay, this is about blacklisting Xiaomi and Snook. After US-Russia pullouts of Open Skies Treaty, the pacts allowed unarmed surveillance. Russia announced on Friday it was pulling out of the Open Skies Treaty, saying that the pact, which allows unarmed surveillance flights over member countries, had been seriously compromised by the withdrawal of the United States. The move announced by Russia's foreign ministry comes days before US President-elected Joe Biden's Jan 20 inauguration, amid fears of burgeoning arms race. Moscow's last major nuclear arms pact with Washington is set to expire next month. Okay. This is last news for today. Trade with China shrank in 2020, deficit at 5-year low. India's export to China, however, jumped to 16% to a record high 20.86 billion as Asia's largest economy consumed more iron ore. India's exports jumped over 16%. India's trade with China declined last year to the lowest level since 2017, with the trade deficit narrowing to a 5-year low as the country imported far fewer goods from its northern neighbor. Bilateral trade slid 5.6% to $87.6 billion, according to new figures from China's General Administration of Customs. India's imports from China shrank by 10.8% to $66.7 billion, marking the lowest level of inbound shipments since 2016. India's exports to China, however, jumped 16%, crossing the $20 billion mark for first time to a record high of $20.86 billion. You can see it is a good thing. Thank you very much. We'll meet again in tomorrow current affairs. Please subscribe, like, comment, and share. Thank you very much.